practice, how Six Sigma is connected, and then some history and principles behind quality, lean, and Six Sigma. I'm very sure all of you have gone through the pre-training videos shared. Some of you could have attended our white belt program. Some of you could have attended our webinar, and definitely that will leverage your learning. But there'll be a few recaps from those sessions. And then how Lean Six Sigma can be used as an operational excellence model. So what is operational excellence and how Lean Six Sigma is going to be helpful in that? And then process improvement approach, right? And what is process improvement approach? What are we supposed to improve actually? And that we will touch. And then we'll also get introduced to Lean. And then in the process, we will also master one tool, which is called Kaizen. So these are the objectives in the first session. So why we need Six Sigma in business? Any organization, they use frameworks, or they call it the approaches. Why? They use it one mainly to improve the profitability. I hope all of you will agree with me, right? Any organization, whatever they are following, they call it Lean, Six Sigma, Agile, you name it, project management, whatever it is, ultimately they wanted to improve the profitability. So we are going to start with what is the profitability. I have divided into two, profit and then ability. Your profit is, we call it the hard benefit or the hard cost, the direct monetary benefit. The other benefits, any improvement project you do, it will not only yield monetary benefit, it will also yield some additional benefit. Hope all of you understand this, right? And those are called, the soft benefit or the soft component of the improvement. So now, how can we improve this profit? We have some existing resource. Any organization will have existing resource. And if we can produce more output using less resources, see, already you have some system, you have processes. Process means input will be converted into output, right? Where input are the resources you provide, and then your process will produce the output. And now I want more profit. When I want more profit, either I should produce more output using the same resources. Hope all of you get my point. Otherwise, we will produce more output using the same resources. Both way your profit can be impacted. All of you understand what I'm saying, right? Either you reduce your input or you straight away increase your output using the same resources. Both way your profit will get impacted. And what is the difference? When I want to produce more output from the same resources, the approach is called, Six Sigma. The approach is called Six Sigma. I have some resources. I'm not going to reduce any resources. I'll use it as it is. But I will see to that I will get more outputs. That means I will reduce the defects in my current process. Current process outputs, if there are any defects, I will reduce it. That is called Six Sigma approach or DMAC project. Those are called DMAC project. Sometimes you may like to produce more output. Parallelly, you may like to reduce your resources also. That is called Lean Six Sigma project. One side, my output is increasing. Other side, the input that goes into my process is also decreased. That is called what? Lean Six Sigma projects, right? And when I do both, what will happen when I...
Combination of both, sir.
Come again?
Combination of these both.
Yes. Combination of Lean and Six Sigma. We call it Lean Six Sigma project. So when I reduce the defect, what will happen? My profit margin will improve. See, the beauty in reducing the defect is whatever amount of defect you are reducing, that means there will be a cost saving. That cost saving will directly add to the profit of the company. If you're running a company, you will understand, right? If there are defects, let's say you are losing 10 lakhs in the form of defects, and all of a sudden you improved the process, you are not producing defects. Now, where these 10 lakhs will go and get added? This 10 lakhs profit will directly get added in your
profit.
Very good. So that is why we say profit margin will improve. That is why we always say Six Sigma is a profit maximization tool. Right. On the other side, when I reduce the input also while maximizing my output, what will happen? My cash flow will improve. My cash flow, because I really don't have to block a lot of money. Isn't it? So improving your cash flow and improving your profit margin, these are called bottom line improvement. These are called bottom line improvement. That means operationally you are very effective and you are very efficient. All right. And now what is top line? What is your top management wants? They want more money. That means they want more revenue. That means they are not, you know, happy with what they are currently getting. That time your focus will be more output from more resources. More resources means you will make additional investment, new investment. Maybe you will require new machines, you develop new products, so you can improve your output by pulling more resources. That means you can expand your capacity, thereby you can increase your market share. That means your focus is on new product development. But at the same time, now we will use an approach called DFSS. What is DFSS? Design for Six Sigma. The methodology for Design for Six Sigma is DMADV. Define, measure, analyze, design, and verify. This will prevent the defects so that this will prevent the defects at the design stage itself. At the design, you will design your products in such a way that the outputs are free from defects and straight away your outputs are at Six Sigma level. All of you understand the three approaches: Six Sigma, Lean Six Sigma, and another one is Design for Six Sigma. Is that clear? Shall we? And now the Design for Six Sigma, since you have increased your, no, the product line, your revenue will now be more. Whether your profit is more or not, that is not my concern. My business has now improved. My market share has now improved. So if you want to improve the bottom line, you can focus on DMAC, that is Six Sigma and Lean Six Sigma. And another thing is, if your focus is on top line, you can run DFSS project. Is that clear to all? Can yes, I get a yes?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
So, little history. So, Six Sigma is conceptualized at the Motorola. You know, Motorola, US-based company, known for their mobile pager kind of products. In 1979, in a management meeting, an executive said like this: the real problem at Motorola is our quality stinks. Quality is going down. Why he is saying like that? Because his market is going down. Because his market is going down, and then he's saying that. And at that time, the chief executive, Robert Bob Galvin, and he realized, so our approach towards quality should be improved, and there is no point simply blaming the result. We should blame the process and the input. So criticizing the process and criticizing the existing resources, criticizing the inputs is important to improve your output. There is no point of criticizing your output always. Sometimes criticizing your process and criticizing your inputs is important to improve your output. And so he threw a challenge saying that there should be a tenfold growth in a span of 5 years. And then the responsibilities were given to some people. They are called Bill Smith and Michael Harry. How all of you are responsible for your company. Similarly, Bill Smith and Michael Harry were responsible for the growth of Motorola under Robert Bob Galvin. And it is Bill Smith, who is an engineer. He actually presented a paper.